specific diagnosis. Anti-retina is basically, it's to miss the colored part of your eye. And so this is a child that has aniridia, but it's actually just really more like a big pupil. But there's not very much of this colored part, you know, you can actually see in his eye. This is just looking at his eye, you can actually see, look into it and see the retina. This one has almost complete aniridia, where the colored part's completely gone. It says that's something that we actually miss to begin with, because we usually dilate these kids' eyes. And so it makes the pupil open up. So when we were looking at him to begin with, everything looked, you know, fine. But then 2 or 3 hours later, when this medication should have worn off, we came back and he still looked like he had huge pupils. And that's when we began thinking, maybe he has aniridia. And indeed, he did. That was important to me because there's only one gene that I know of that can cause aniridia. And I know exactly what gene it is and where it's located. It's a gene called PAC6. It's super important for how your eye develops. And it sits on chromosome 11. I said, if that's true, this child has aniridia, and all these other things too, then I'm thinking that maybe that gene is missing, and perhaps he's also missing other genes around that area. And so I said, I know exactly what I want. I want to do a chromosome analysis. And I guess this is going to cut me off a little bit. But basically, the idea is this. Just a quick review of biology. Your body is made up of all kinds of cells. Eye cells, heart cells, diaphragm cells. In each one of those cells, there are chromosomes that contain the genetic material that we inherit from our mom and from our dad. If you were to stretch those chromosomes out, they're all made out of DNA. And then we're looking at specific genes or specific instructions for how that cell is supposed to work in the body. Now, I can't see a gene. It's too small. I can't even really see a single piece of DNA. It is too small. But you can see chromosomes because there's so much DNA all concentrated in a little package, you can actually see them underneath the microscope. And so what I asked them to do is to take a blood sample, send it to the lab, where they would actually look at the chromosomes under a microscope and tell me if a piece of that was missing, with my biggest interest being on chromosome 11, where this PAC6 gene exists. Now, this is a little bit blurry. I wish you could kind of kill the lights, but we'll go for it. This is what chromosomes look like when you look at them under a microscope. They look like kind of little rods with little black and white segments, if you want to think about that. This is chromosome 11, which is one I was interested in, all blown up. And this would be a normal pattern. We number them from the very largest chromosomes, which is 1, all the way down to the very smallest, which are actually off the screen, which is 21 and 22. But again, this would be a normal pattern. We said, look at chromosome 11 and tell us if there's something that's wrong. So for this child, this is this child's chromosome 11. And this is kind of a diagram of what it's supposed to look like. And it has, again, light and dark bands. And this is a normal chromosome. And it's hard for you up here close, but I think you do this with me. This is the white that goes here. And then it goes gray, white, black. A little key is the white, gray. And then it goes white, black, etc. And you lock down the bands. Each one of those bands may have 10, 20, 100 genes in it. But we're looking for that pattern. If the pattern is broken, it means that there's something wrong with that particular chromosome. And you're either missing pieces, or you can also add pieces. Either way, you basically break the balance that you need in order to be able to form a body correctly, or form an eye correctly. And so in this case, this is a chromosome that does not look normal. And if you look, it has a white band, then a gray, then a white, then a gray, and then it actually jumps this whole section. You get a little tiny piece of white, and then it goes to black, white, gray, and then all of a sudden you're off to the other side of the chromosome. So this child's missing a huge piece of chromosome 11. Exactly where we expected, because you know the PAC6, right, sits right there. So, From this point, you say, okay, we know the PAC6 is really important for eyes. And so just by knowing that the PAC6 gene is gone, I can explain why he has clouded corneas, why he has high pressure, I explain why he has aniridia. But what about the other genes, like the undescended testes and the kidney anomalies? Well, there's another gene that sits in that called WT1. WT1 is a gene that's really important for how those organs are made. And we know that kids that have mutations in WT1 end up with those kind of problems. So far, so good. We're perfect. We have a piece that's missing, two genes that are really important in development, both of them are gone. The question then, though, is what about this diaphragmatic hernia? This is off the screen. Can you explain that somehow? Now, I was just starting, but, you know, I know how to use the internet and how to try to check things out. And so I said, well, is it possible that WT1, this gene is so important in how you make certain parts of your body, what is it also possible that that also can cause diaphragmatic hernias? And so I went to just the internet and said, you know, can we find any cases where that's the case? First thing I found was that there were two children that had been previously described had chromosome 11 deletions and also had diaphragmatic hernia. Now you have to remember there's a lot of kids who have deletions in this area. And there's only two in the whole history that's ever been reported that have diaphragmatic hernia. But Lisa said that yes, I'm not the only one who's seen this in a child. And then the next thing was, well, have there ever been any children that have WT1 mutations, so actual changes within the gene, that have diaphragmatic hernia? And the answer is, in all